Thank you, Arvind Prabhu, to remind me. So, Hare Krishna, I welcome you to this course of Gita Gyan, Essence of Bhagavad Gita by ISKCON Malaysia. So, okay. So, this is the adult, no? The darshan of this beautiful picture of the deity, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Mahaprabhu. So hopefully there is no line breakage, no internet, computer hang, no problem. So we can, hopefully we can end this session very smoothly. The prayers. Om Adinanjanana Timirandasya Chanandana Shalakya Chakshirun Militana Yena Kasmisi Guru Venamaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shrimade Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namini. Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharini Nirvisita Sunyavadi Pachiti Dishatarini Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Siyar Advaita Gadadara Shivashari Guru Bhakti Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So all glories to His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Swami Srila Prabhupada ki. So Arvind Prabhu, would you like to?
Ye sranvanti padanti eva gita sastram aharnisam nate vai manusya jneya deva rupa na samsaya. One who day and night hears and recites the Gita is never to be taken as a mere human being. Without a doubt, he is a veritable God.
Thank you, Prabhupada. So this is a heavy statement from Gita Mahatmaya that one who day and night means 24 hours reading this Gita, recite the Gita, is never taken better as a human being. So one who reads the Bhagavad Gita 24 hours actually is not a human being. Without a doubt, is a veritable God. Veritable God is mean like a demigod or like an angel. They are worshipping like an angel. So actually it's not ordinary. So in a very understandable way, we can put he's not an ordinary human. So we have Bhagavad Gita in front of our eyes, right? So take the opportunity to read Bhagavad Gita, not every day, not 24 hours a day, but each page one day. So starting from today, those who have Bhagavad Gita, try to actually read one page one day, making that as a habit. It will change your entire life. Trust me, this is what I have experienced in my life. Not only myself, but so much of people out there that this Bhagavad Gita has actually changed their entire life. So even though some of the things we couldn't understand, but try to at least read one page one day before sleep or before going to work or whatever. So I used to read before going to work. So when morning, when I do my prayers, I chant my rounds, I finish my rounds, I used to read one page of Bhagavad Gita. So my target will be three verses. So three sloka, I read at least three sloka per day and go to work. So whatever happened, hook or crook, I will do that. So it naturally will become our habit. You don't have to remind. So practice it. So it will be a better, you see the changes in your life. In a better way, in a better human way. So, and there is one Chinese Mataji. Yes, this Bhagavad Gita is also available in Chinese language. So if you don't have it, so please PM me or personally message me. I will guide you how to buy this Bhagavad Gita. So chapter 9 is the most confidential knowledge. That is the most confidential knowledge. So this is the one of the, this chapter is actually one of the most important chapter. Because of this chapter, the whole Bhagavad Gita is actually appreciated by the whole world. This is because of this chapter. Krishna giving so much of secrets here. So anything which is carried out from last previous chapter 8. So it's any volunteer would like to share. Or I can ask, what is the chapter title name of chapter 8? Anyone remember? Or you are just seeing the notes now? The titles of yesterday's chapter. Maybe I can go for... Yes, Arvindan Prabhu.
The chapter title is Attaining the Supreme.
Thank you so much. Yes, Attaining Supreme. But I have heard another voice which is coming, Attaining the Supreme. But anyway, thank you for both of you. Yes, Attaining the Supreme. So that is the actually one, that is the most beautiful chapter actually. Chapter is also, every chapter is actually important. So any lesson which you learned from yesterday's chapter, Kausalya Mataji, would you like to try? Any lesson? Even you chanting this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, this is what I have learned from yesterday's chapter, Prabhu. Yes, I will accept it. So anything, any single thing. Vijayalakshmi Mataji, would you like to try? Anything you learned from yesterday's chapter? Okay, I go for Kokashalvi Mataji. Would you like to share?
I'll try.
Yes, Madam. Please.
I think chanting Hare Krishna's name.
Yes, beautiful Mataji. Yes, actually, yes, chanting of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Another thing that I would like to go is Ante Kale Chamam Eva Shamarana Mukta Kalevaram. So one who remember me at the time of the death, upon leaving the body, will never take birth in this material world, but attain my spiritual abode. Krishna declaring that in Bhagavad Gita says that is the most important. So we have to ready. So in relevant to this, there is some beautiful quote, which is life is in a preparation, death is examination. So whatever you do in your life now, the exam will be tested at the end of your life. This is for sure. This is very sure. Okay, so we have to prepare from now. Therefore, we are not preparing to die, but we have to, in that consciousness, we have to be in God consciousness. So in that case, we have to always engage, make our life in such a way that we always remember God. So we have to chant, we have to read Bhagavad Gita. For by just doing that, hearing and listening, hearing and chanting. So yesterday we see 9 types of devotional service, which is most important, which is the 3 is the basic, which is listening, hearing, chanting and remembering. So these 3 is the very basic. You just hear what any lecture of Bhagavad Gita or whatever, where is the God, the name is that been glorified, you just hear. By that, automatically you will chant. And by doing these 2, you will automatically remember Vishnu. So it's a very easy process. So, but we have to do carefully. That's the main thing. We have to do carefully. Like Bharata Maharaj, we have to do carefully. So, Shashin Prabhu, do you like to?
Yeah, sure. Sri Bhagavan Vacha. Iram tu te guya tamam pravaksme anasu yave jnanam vijnana sahidam yaj janatava moksyane subhad. The Supreme Personality of God's Head said, my dear Arjuna, because you are never envious of me, I shall impart to you this most confidential knowledge and realization. knowing which you shall be relieved of the miseries of material existence.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you. So Krishna telling Arjuna here, the Supreme Personality of Godhead said, my dear Arjuna, because you are never envious of me, that's the important keyword, that you are never envious of me, I shall impart to you this most confidential knowledge. Why it is most confidential knowledge? Why actually the first thing, why actually Krishna telling this to Arjuna? Why not to other? Why Krishna actually choose Arjuna? Why Krishna actually choose Arjuna? There are actually so much of reason why Krishna chooses Arjuna. Why not other people? Why not Karna? Why not Duryodhana? Actually, who is actually doing bad? Duryodhana, right? So who should we teach the lesson? So Duryodhana. So why should Krishna choose the innocent one, but not, why not the bad one? Right? The police usually do catch the bad guy and advise them, don't do this. But Krishna here do something opposite, which he telling everything to Arjuna, but not Duryodhana. But why Krishna telling this to Arjuna? Because Arjuna is not envious of Krishna. So he don't want to be lot of this material nature, but whereby Duryodhana is not like that. He wanted to be king. He wants to be the lord. He wants to be claimed as a lord. He wants to be the lord of the material nature. So therefore, whatever Krishna tells to Duryodhana, Duryodhana would never understand. Nee solradha na kekkanuma. So in that mentality, actually Duryodhana is. Nee solradha, nee enatha solradha, na enatha kekkare. So that type of mentality actually Duryodhana. So whatever you tell, Duryodhana will never listen. Actually, Krishna try advise Duryodhana also, but Duryodhana tell Krishna, I know everything. Duryodhana tell, I know everything, Krishna. But the one who is actually don't know is Arjuna. So you please tell him. Whatever you tell to me, you tell Arjuna. So he will follow. I will never follow because I know everything. So that's why Arjuna is considered not envious. So whatever we do, which is claim everything for ourselves. I am this, I am that, I. When we put the word I, the false ego come. When the false ego come, we forget God. So in other way, we can say we are enemies of the God. When we give every credit to the Lord, whatever we do, we might do it, but not we do. Because forgetfulness, remembrance and knowledge is coming from the God. Right? Knowledge, forgetfulness and remembrance. Sorry, intelligence, forgetfulness and remembrance is coming from him. Krishna will tell that in chapter 15, that knowledge, remembrance, and intelligence. Sorry, knowledge, remembrance, intelligent remembrance, and forgetfulness is coming from me. Chapter 15, Krishna will tell that. So in that case, whatever it's coming through to us is the mercy of the God. So in this way, whatever we get, we have to give the credit to God. By the grace of God, everything happens. But when we try to lord over this material nature, we will become the Lord. Therefore, we will forget the relationship with God. So in this case, we are envious. So whatever we study could not understand. So because of Arjuna, never envious. And Krishna tells, I give this confidential knowledge and realizing, knowing which you shall be revealed of the material necessaries. So, and we see picture number 2, because we are envious. Because of we are envious, why? Now we can ask the question, if we want to go back to the Godhead and will never return, why God have put us in this situation, right? This is the very logic question. You all, Prabhu, you want to me go back to the Godhead. But now, why am I here? If God is really dear to us, why am I here in this material world? Why should I go through all this? Because we are envious of the Lord. That's why we are sent to this material world. We are actually part and partial of the God. But because out of the envious, in the Shastra it is stated, out of envious we are put in the material world. So the intelligent people will always think of how to go out from here. It's not questioning why we came here. If you get corona, what the first thing you will do? Will get a treatment, right? Will go quarantine yourself. Will think how to get from this problem. How to get from this coronavirus, right? That is the first thing we will do. We will never think where I get this corona. Wherever, where, which place I have visited. No, that is actually the intelligent man will never think like that. They will think how to get out from this problem, how to cure this corona. That's the main solution, right? Whatever sick you get, fever, cough, you will try to eat some medicine, you know, taking a proper diet, and make sure that you are getting out of the sick. You will never research or think why I get this sick. Okay? So similarly, we also have to be in that way, thinking in that way that how to get out from this material world, rather than thinking why am I coming here. Okay, what you gonna do, the thinking about that, nothing gonna happen, nothing gonna change. But thinking how to get out from this is the learned person. This is how the learned person will think. So Krishna tells, those who are not envious, I will give this knowledge. Well, come out from this material misery. So because of Arjuna, he's not envious, he can hear about this confidential knowledge. And Krishna tells in the next verse that this Bhagavad Gita is the Rajavitya Rajaguyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam Parayakshayagam Dharmayam Shushukam Kartum Avyayam. So maybe I can ask Tinisha Mataji, would you like to read? Then Sangeeta Mataji, you can read.
Raja Vitya Raja Guyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam Pratyaksha Bhagamam Dharmyam Susugam Kartum Avyayam. This knowledge is the king of education, the most secret of all secrets. It is the purest knowledge, and because it gives direct perception of the self by realization, it is the perfection of religion, it is everlasting, and it is joyfully performed.
Thank you, Mataji. So Krishna tells this Bhagavad Gita, this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita is Rajavitya Rajaguyam. Rajavitya means it is the knowledge of king. It is this knowledge is actually king of education. Why king of education? Because what I have been teaching is this Bhagavad Gita to differentiate between spirit and matter. What is spirit? What is matter? Right? What is soul? What is body? In any academic, there is actually no academic teaching about the science of the soul. Name one academic which is teach about the science of soul. Name one academic in this world. Even the Oxford University, the number one university in the world, will never teach the science of God. They merely teach anything and any science or whatever they teach, but not science of the God. No, the science of the soul. Right? So that's why Krishna telling here that this knowledge, the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita is actually king of education. Those who understand the science of the soul, those who understand this, I am not this body, I am spirit soul, this soul is part and partial of the God, is actually very intelligent. So Krishna vandu yaarukku inda atma vinyanam theriyiradho is the most intelligent. And he telling that Arjuna, don't talk like a pandita. Pandita means very learned scholar. Do not talk like a pandita, Arjuna. This is chapter 2. Krishna telling, one of the purport, Rupat, right? They do not talk like a pandita. The pandita means learned scholar, but they don't know nothing. They don't know the science of the soul. But who knows the science of the soul is very intelligent. And that's why this Bhagavad Gita is king of education. And the most secret of all the secrets. It is most secret. Why? Because it's giving the direct perception of these devotional services. Any sannyasi, any renounced order of people might be from the other side of the world. They are talking out of mental speculation, but they never teach us the soul, the science, this God. this devotional service by chanting this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, you get, this is the most easiest process. No one teaches except one person who teaches to the whole world is A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. So that's why we name Srila Prabhupada as the founder Acharya. And he built the house where everyone, the world can be. No, he built the house where the whole world can be. So that's why it is the secret of all the secrets. And it is the purest. Pavitram. Pavitram means purest. And it is give direct perception of the self-realization. Now it's give direct perception. It's not indirect. It's directly giving you. You all are part and partial of the God. And it is everlasting. Avyayam. Avyayam means it's everlasting. And it is joyfully performed. No one will be sad by doing this devotional service. No one will be coming sad by chanting this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. It is joyfully performed. It's not by sadly performed. You can see the number two picture that the devotee is chanting and dancing in ecstasy. See, their face is so bliss. So we can understand. Because Krishna tell, I am full of knowledge, full of bliss, and eternal, full of bliss. There's no question of sadness here. So that's the actual nature of the soul. So Krishna giving here 8 types of information. So this Bhagavad Gita is one thing of education. And the second thing is secret of all the secret. And it is the purest. Fourth, it is giving the direct perception. And it is perfection of religion. This is Dharmayam. Dharmayam means perfection of religion. And then it is give direct perception. Number 6. Give direct perception. Number 7 is it is everlasting, eternal. Even after your death, the consciousness will be always there because the consciousness belongs to the soul. It's not to the body. How to identify that the body have soul or not? By consciousness. We have consciousness, right? Therefore, the soul is there. And it is joyfully performed. Susukam karukum. Susukam means joyfully performed. So that's why Krishna tells this is the most. The title of this chapter is, what is the title of this chapter? Rajeshwari Masaji.
The most confidential, yes. Knowledge.
The most confidential knowledge. So we can see the answer is in the bottom of this slide. Yes, Mataji. Continue, Mataji.
Avajananti mamuda manusim tanum ashritam param bhavam ajananto mama buddha maheswaram. Fools deride me when I descend in the human form. They do not know my transcendental nature as the supreme lord of all that be.
Thank you. Thank you, Mataji. So Krishna actually come here to this material world to actually play the pastimes. Pastimes in Vrindavana, Mathura, Dauraka, and people thinking that he's a normal human being. Even though he looks like a normal human being, but does not have body like that. Hey, in the Brahma Shamita, Brahma telling he is Sachit Ananda Vigraha. Even though in battlefield of Kurukshetra, he's the oldest. Okay, he's the oldest. His age at that time is, I'm not sure what his age, but he looked ever young in the whole war. In the whole war, in the war of Kurukshetra, he's the only one who is very young, like a 20 years old boy. So in this case, he's not an ordinary. He has a Sachit Ananda Vigraha. His body is not like us. So when we wake up, we have to go to washroom or take our bath, but for Krishna, it's not like that. You don't have to do that because it's Sachit Ananda. Okay, do you know, do that for the deity? No, right? So similarly, his body is Sachit Ananda Vigraha, everlasting, eternal, blessed and full of knowledge. It's not like us. There is no death, birth, for. So that's why he is you know, there is a pastime of him killing the Kamsa, Putana, Shushupal. So this is the story when Krishna is coming. And then Yamuna Devi Mataji, would you like to read?
Mahatman, diving, captain, Ashita, Bajan, and Manasu, Buddha, Dim, Avia, Yam, O son of Prabhupada, those who are not deluded, the great soul are under the protection of the divine nature. They are fully engaged in devotional service because they know me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, original and inexhaustible.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the contribution. So, son of Prasa, those who are not deluded, the great soul under the protection of divine nature. Those who are not deluded, which means those persons who have completely faith on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna tells, they are actually in under my protection. Like the story of Draupadi. We all know the story, the world famous story. You know, Krishna giving the tremendous of sari, and she was lifting his two hands and surrendered completely to the Lord. You know, even the husband couldn't save them, but Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he came and saved us at the last minute. And we know the story of Prahlad Maharaj, tremendous of difficulty that Prahlad Maharaj had gone through. But at the end of the day, the Lord himself appeared. And now we can see the direct story from Arjuna. He's protecting Arjuna. But before he protecting Arjuna, he giving tremendous of test that Arjuna go through. So much of test Arjuna go through. But he never give up. He never give up on his devotee. He is Arjuna, the devotee is always under protection of him. They are fully engaged in devotional service because they know me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So when Prabhupada, his divine grace Prabhupada left India carrying the Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita to preach to the Western country. So at that time, there is no spiritual knowledge in the Western country. Prabhupada go in a ship called Jaladuta. So in the Jaladuta ship, Prabhupada writes in diary that he has heart attack. He had a heart attack, two heart attacks. But Krishna comes into his dream and he dreaming like Krishna is saving him. And he survived that heart attack and came to the Western country and propagate this Krishna consciousness to the entire world in 10 years. In the age of 96, in the age of 69, Prabhupada went to India and propagate this Krishna consciousness to the Western country. And yes, this Krishna consciousness separates two out of the world. So this is the one of the examples that Krishna actually save his devotee in every situation. And then Krishna tell that maybe Satish Kumar Mahaprabhu, would you like to try?
Yes, sure. Ananyas Chintayanto Mam Ye Jana Paryu Pasade Pesam Nitya Piyuktanam Yoga Ksemum Vahami Aham. But those who always worship me with the exclusive devotion, meditating on my transcendental form, to them I carry what they lack and I preserve what they have.
Thank you so much, Guru. Thank you. So Krishna tells here, but those who always worship me with exclusive devotion, the word exclusive devotion will be tested in your quiz. So the answer I'm giving here now is exclusive devotion. So meditating on my transcendental form, to them, I carry what they lack and preserve what they have. So Krishna never see what you have. Krishna never see any perfection like Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj is actually a great devotee, but he never see any perfection. But simply chanting the holy name of God in any situation, Prahlad Maharaj, God actually is Prahlad Maharaj. So at the end of the day, Krishna actually save Prahlad Maharaj, protect Prahlad Maharaj. So how do they actually engage in devotional service? They are full engaged in devotional service. They just don't don't not sit quiet meditation, but they engage everything, whatever they have, they engage in the service of the Lord. And they come under the complete protection of Krishna. If Krishna wants to kill someone, no one could save them. If Krishna wants to save someone, no one could kill them. This is the most most famous quote from Srimad Bhagavatam, that if Krishna wanted to kill someone, he wanted to kill Ravana, he wanted to kill Hiranyakashipu, even though they are great king or great, they have a great boon. But Krishna decided, I will kill you. So whatever situation, Krishna will kill them. So if Krishna wants to protect someone, if Krishna is protecting Draupadi, Prahlad Maharaj, and Ambarisha Maharaj, and so on, so on. There are so much of people in Krishna. No one would kill them. So this is what Krishna is trying to tell. To them, I carry what they lack and I preserve what they have. And this is the most beautiful verse that Krishna declaring here, that patram pusham phalam soyam yome bhaktiya prashayate sat aham bhakti pradaham asnami parayatmanam. So maybe I can ask Rina Sri Mataji, would you like to read? Yes, Ashok Kumar Prabhu.
Patram pushpam palam toyam yomi bhaktya prayachati tat aham bhakti upartham asnami prayatmana. If one offers me with love and devotion a leaf, a flower, a fruit or water, I will accept it.
Thank you, Prabhu. So Krishna actually destroying so much of philosophy system here. So Krishna telling here that if one offer with me love, with love and devotion, a leaf, a flower, a fruit or water, I will accept it. So no any material position or possession, material paraphernalia actually can buy God. Only love and devotion. There is a story which is significant to these verses. I would like to tell the story of Duryodhana and Krishna. So Krishna actually come to talk to Duryodhana. So Krishna vandu Duryodhana paakkaradhukku varar. Edhukku? Amedi pesuradhukku. Samadhanama poyiralam, pirachana vendam nendradhu pesuradhukku vandu Krishna actually Duryodhana paakka varar. And Krishna actually coming to meet Duryodhana for the diplomatic talk. Because Duryodhana won war, right? So before that, before the war happened, Krishna actually came to see Duryodhana for the peace talk. For the peace talk. So these news have been heard by Duryodhana. So in the visayam vandu Duryodhana ku theriya varudhu. And Dronacharya and Bhishma, they were on the site of Duryodhana advising Duryodhana that, hey, Krishna going to come and see you. So Krishna is not an ordinary man, because they are a great Mahajans. They know that is Krishna is not an ordinary man. He is something, a supreme personality of God. So if you take Krishna on our side, the victory is for us. So the Dronacharya irukum Bhishma devargalukum theriyum varadhu Krishna Paramapurusha Bhagavan. So Krishna ra namba pakkatta iluthukitta vetri namakku endru Duryodhana irukum vandu solranga. But at the same time, they're telling that that is not very easy. Adu solabam kadaiyadu Duryodhana. Krishna ra namba pakkatta irukkiradhu solabam kadaiyadu. So in that way, when receiving these news, Duryodhana have intention to take Krishna in his side. Not only Krishna, but his army also. But Duryodhana is more concerned on Krishna's army. In the first chapter, we see when Krishna asking what you want, and Arjuna choosing Krishna and Duryodhana choose the armies of Krishna. So in that way, we are all in the mentality of Duryodhana by choosing what the Lord wants. But we want everything belongs to God, but not the Lord. The same, Duryodhana actually has the intention to take the armies of Krishna, but not actually Krishna. But because of these both great various tell, Duryodhana have the mindset to take Krishna. So actually, when the Duryodhana and Govinda, Krishna mele pattru kadaiyadu, Krishna roda அரசாங்கம் மேடம் அதாவது கிருஷ்ணரோட ராஜ்யம் கிருஷ்ணரோட அந்த அவரோட போர் அவரோட போர் வீரர்கள் மேலதான் துரியோதனுக்கு வந்து ஒரு சின்ன ஒரு கண்ணு இவங்க சொன்னனால ஓகே நான் ட்ரை பண்ணி பாக்குறேன்னு துரியோதனன் கூறியது. ஸோ வாட் ஹேப்பன் இன் தி பாத்வே இன் தி ஹஸ்தினாபுரம் ஃப்ரம் தி பாத்வே த கிருஷ்ணா காம் அர்ஜுன் துரியோதன் ஆக்சுவலி டெக்கரேட்டட் வித் ஜெவல்ஸ் அண்ட் ஜெவல்ஸ் அண்ட் டைமண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஸோ மச் ஆஃப் பேரபெரேனாலியா. ஸோ அந்த கிருஷ்ணர் வர வழியை எல்லாம் துரியோதனன் வந்து நெகையும் வைதூரியங்களையும் வந்து ஜொலிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சு. ஸோ கிருஷ்ணர்லாம் இதை பார்த்துட்டு வா அசந்து போயிடுவாருன்னு நினைச்சு அவர் வந்து துரியோதனன் வந்து அந்த வர வழியெல்லாம் வந்து நெகையங்க வைரங்கள்ல வைதூரியங்கள்ல பிரம்மாண்டமா அந்த அஸ்தினாபுரத்தையே வந்து ஜோடிக்க வச்சிட்டாரு. So in that way, he decorating the pathway of Krishna with the jewels and so many of paraphernalias and make it like a festival. And Krishna also come and seeing all these paraphernalias and starting to talk peace. So Krishna ram vandu amedhikaga pesumbodhu and Duryodhana refused to give the peace, refused to give what this Arjuna's want, what the Pandavas want, what is the portion of Pandavas. Okay. Actually, the problem is coming from the land. சொத்து பிரச்சனை வந்துடும். இப்ப நம்ம குடும்பத்திலாம் சொத்து பிரச்சனை வர்ற மாதிரி அங்கேயே வந்துருச்சு. துரோப்பர யுகத்திலே வந்து தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் துரோப்பர யுகத்திலே இந்த பிரச்சனை வந்துருச்சு. ஸோ அவ வந்து அது துரியோதனன் சொல்றான், கிருஷ்ணர் வந்து அமைதி பேசும்போது துரியோதனன் சொல்றான், குண்டு ஊசி கூடியும் குண்டு ஊசி இருக்கிற இடத்துக்கூடியும் நான் பாண்டவர்களுக்கு தர முடியாது. ஸோ ஐ கேனாட் கிவ் எனி திங் டு தி பாண்டவர். So in that way, Krishna asked him that then it will be end up in war. Krishna vandu solraru adu sandeye la poi mudiyum Duryodhana. So and Duryodhana is more favorable to fight. So Duryodhananukkum adu mela dhaan aasa endradhu vandu Duryodhana nam kaanchitaru. So actually inga onnor vishayam enna irukudhuna Krishna vandu inga Krishna oda vishwarupatha vandu kaanchiruvaar. Krishna dhaan mudhal mudhal endra kadaval endru Krishna dhaan bhagavan endradhu vandu Duryodhananta vandu actually oru chinna ஒரு குழு வந்து கொடுத்துருவாரு, ஒரு விஸ்வரூபத்தை காமிச்சிருவாரு. அந்த விஸ்வரூபத்தை 11th சாப்டர்ல வந்து பார்ப்போம். ஆக்சுவலி ஹியர் கிருஷ்ணா வில் ஷோ ஹிஸ் யூனிவர்சல் ஃபார்ம் அண்ட் எஸ் வி வில் சி தட் தி சாப்டர் 11 விச் இஸ் யூனிவர்சல் ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா பட் ஆக்சுவலி கிருஷ்ணா வில் ஷோ ஹியர். ஸோ இன் டீட்டெயில்ஸ் வி வில் சி இன் தி சாப்டர் 11. ஸோ ஆஃப்டர் தட் துரியோதனா நோ குக்கிங் குக்ட் வெரைட்டிஸ் ஆஃப் palatable food for Krishna and ask Krishna, invite Krishna for dining. So Krishna ra saapradhukku vandu Duryodhanan vandu palavigamana saapadugal unavugala samichu vechi Krishna ra kooparam and Krishna vandu saapada maattaar and Krishna refused to eat. And then Krishna coming out from the Hastinapur, Krishna vandu anda aranma adhaadhu Hastinapur thottu veliye vandu அஸ்தினாபுர் பக்கத்துல வந்து யாரோட வீட்டுக்கு போறாரு, விதுரா வீட்டுக்கு போறாரு. அண்ட் கிருஷ்ணா கோஸ் டு தி ஹவுஸ் ஆஃப் விதுரா விச் இஸ் பிசைட் ஆஃப் தி பேலஸ் ஆஃப் துரியோதனா அண்ட் ஹி சீ தி ஸ்மால் ஹவுஸ் ஆஃப் விதுரா. விதுரா ஆக்சுவலி இன் தி சைட் ஆஃப் துரியோதனா பட் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி பியூர் டியூட்டி ஆஃப் தி லார்ட். இஸ் லைக் பீஷ்மதேவர், பீஷ்மதேவர் இஸ் ஆல்சோ இன் தி சைட் ஆஃப் துரியோதனா பட் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி கிரேட் மகாஜன், இஸ் கிரேட் டியூட்டி ஆஃப் பியூர் டியூட்டி ஆஃப் தி லார்ட். So therefore, same, Vidura also in the same way is very pure and is very poor. It's very poor. Vidura is very pure, poor, and he living in a small house beside Hastinapur. And Krishna stopped the chariot in front of Vidura's house and went into the Vidura's house. And in the house, there is no Vidura, but he saw the wife of Vidura. So Vidura vittu pomode, Vidura vandu romba ஏழையான ஒரு பக்தர். அவர் அந்த குடிசையில வந்து தங்கிட்டு இருக்கும் போது கிருஷ்ணர் வந்து அவர் ரதத்தை வந்து முன்னுக்கு நிப்பாட்டி அந்த வீட்டுக்கு போகும்போது அங்க விதுரா இல்ல, ஆனா விதுராவோட கொண்டாடி இருக்காங்க. Her name is Vidura Rani. அவங்க பேர் வந்து விதுர ராணி. And after seeing Krishna in front of her, she was you know jammed, she was shocked. She don't know what to do. So கிருஷ்ணரை பார்த்த கையும் மோடல காலும் மோடல, அவங்க அப்படியே செல மாறி நின்றா நிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சிட்டாங்க. He was astonished. He was shocked, seeing Krishna in front of her. because Krishna himself is come, oh Krishna, and she don't know what to do. And Krishna asked Vidura Rani, I'm very hungry, but you give me some food. எனக்கு ரொம்ப பசிக்குது, எனக்கு கொஞ்சம் உணவு கிடைக்குமா? ஸோ இன் தேட் கேஸ் நோ விதுர ராணி ஷி டிசைட் அண்ட் டேக் ஒன் பனனா ஷி டேக் ஒன் பனனா அண்ட் பீல் தி பனனா அண்ட் த்ரோ தி பனனா இன் டு டஸ்ட்பின் அண்ட் கிவ் தி பீல் தி ஸ்கின் ஆஃப் பனனா டு கிருஷ்ணா. ஸோ அவங்க வந்து அந்த அந்த கையமோட அந்த அதிர்ச்சியில வந்து வாழைப்பழத்தை எடுக்கிறாங்க, வாழைப்பழ தோலை உரிச்சிட்டு வாழைப்பழத்தை வந்து குப்பை தொட்டியில போட்டுட்டு வாழைப்பழத்தோலை பகவான் தர. ஸோ கிருஷ்ணா வாஸ் ஆக்சுவலி என்ஜாயிங் த ஸ்கின் ஆஃப் தி பனனா. கிருஷ்ணா நோஸ் தட் ஷி இஸ் நாட் கிவிங் தி ரைட் திங், பட் ஷி கிவிங் தி ஸ்கின் ஆஃப் தி பனனா அவுட் ஆஃப் தி ஷாக்ட். ஷி நெவர் கம் அவுட் ஃப்ரம் இஸ் ஷாக்ட் அண்ட் ஷி கிவ் அவுட் ஆஃப் எக்டசி, அவுட் ஆஃப் எக்டசி ஷி டோன் வாட் ஷி இஸ் டூயிங், ஷி கிவ் தி ஸ்கின் அண்ட் அவுட் ஆஃப் தட் கிருஷ்ணா டேக்கிங் தி ஸ்கின் அண்ட் என்ஜாயிங் தி ஸ்கின். கிருஷ்ணர் வந்து கிருஷ்ணருக்கும் தெரியும் அது வாழைப்பழம் கிடையாது, வாழைப்பழம் தோடுதானே, அண்ட் ஸ்டீல் கிருஷ்ணஸ் என்ஜாய். கிருஷ்ணர் வந்து அதை பயங்கரமா ருசிச்சு சாப்பிட்றாரு. அண்ட் கொஞ்ச நேரம் கூடயும் இல்லை விதுரா வந்துட்டேன், விதுரா வந்து பார்த்துட்டு இந்த காட்சியை பார்த்துட்டு உனக்கு விதுரா பயங்கரமா கோபம் அடைகிறாரு. அண்ட் ஏசுறாரு அவர் கொண்டாட்டியால, முட்டால நீ என்ன செய்யற, கிருஷ்ணர் வந்திருக்காரு நீ பழந்தோலை தரேன்ட்டு. அண்ட் விதுரா வந்து பழத்தை உரிச்சு பழம் தராரு. இன் தேட் வே விதுரா காம் அண்ட் சடன்லி விதுரா காம் Vidura came and entered into the house, and Vidura saw the scene. Vidura saw the scenario, what is happening, and Vidura scolding his wife, oh, the useless one, Krishna is here, and you are giving the skin of the banana to Krishna. This is scolding Krishna, Vidura Rani's wife, and taking another banana and peel the banana and giving the fruit of banana. And Krishna accepted that too. Krishna accepted that too and ate the banana and commenting Vidura that the fruit that the prasadam that your wife give is more sweeter than what you have given. நீ கொடுத்த பழத்தோட உன் பொண்டாட்டி கொடுத்த அந்த தோல் ஒன்று ருசியா இருக்கு. அதாவது கிருஷ்ணா நக்கலா வந்து விதுரா வந்து நக்கல் அடிக்கிறார். So in that way we can understand that we cannot, whatever we have, we might have big money, big bank balance, big houses, big car or big position, we cannot buy God. We cannot buy devotion. We might give him hundred and thousand of charity in the name of fame, you know, in the order to get the name. But then that's not actually bhakti. Bhakti is not coming like in that way. So don't be in the mentality of Duryodhana. People are doing that. But Krishna tell, if you want offer with me, with love and devotion, early, a flower, a fruit, or what, I will accept it. So bhakti is not dependent on the material paraphernalia. Even the poorest among the poor can do this. Okay? For the poor, he can get one leaf, one flower, and offer it to the Bhagavan. And one flower of water or fruit, he can offer it to the God. And Krishna tell, I will accept it. In order to you giving so much of things, so much of paraphernalia, so much of cooking, but what is the point when there is no love and devotion? So in this way, we as a devotee practicing that whatever we cook, we might cook and bake big, even though, you know, Krishna is asking even a leaf and flower also it's enough, but that is not the analogy. So we can, whatever we cook, you know, in the proper way, in the proper instruction, following the rules and regulatives. So we offer to that, to God, so we taking that as a prasadam. So even you might ask him, so being vegetarian is also a why this leaf and trees are the is not a living entity, it's also sin, Prabhu, you might ask. Yes, it is also sin, killing a vegetables or whatever living entity. But Krishna tell here in the purport, Prabhupada tell that if one offer that to the God, to the Lord, to Krishna, it is sin free. Krishna tell, Sarva Dharma Paricharya, Maam Ekam Saranam Vraja, Havam Tamam Sarva Pavapiyam Mokshashi Amin Maksuja. Sarva Dharma Paricharya, this is from chapter 16. This sloka is from chapter 16. Sarva Dharma Paricharya, Maam Ekam Saranam Vraja. Give up all the religious principle and surrender only unto me. I will release you from all the sinful reaction. Krishna giving the word. Sarva Dharma Paricharya, Maam Ekam Saranam Vraja. Avam tavam sarva pavapyo. I will release you from all the sinful reaction. Do not be Arjuna. So in this way, whatever we have, we offer to the Lord and we eat that as a remnant food of the Lord. We eat that as a prasadam. And actually, that is purifier. That is giving the purity. In that way, we are sin free. It is not affected by the sinful, any sinful reaction. Even if it is vegetarian, sometimes if we are not offered to the God, it is stated that it is sin. But one who offers that to the God, Krishna tells, that is sin free. Actually, how to offer? You know, you can cook a very nice dish in vegetarian. You can cook anything in vegetarian. So avoid onion and garlic. So usually devotee will avoid onion and garlic. We will see why we actually avoid onion and garlic in further chapter. And you can separate the pot and offer that to the Lord by putting that tulasi. And you can chant Hare Krishna 5 times for the beginners. Who don't know the mantra, you can chant actually 5 times. And then Krishna, you eat. And then after that, we take the remnant food of the remnant food which is offered to the Lord. In that way, it will become prasadam. It's a very simple process. And there is, so those who have Bhagavad Gita, please read this purport. It's very, very nicely written in that purport. So the last verse is, I can request Sumita Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Mana mana bhava mad bhakto mad yaji mama namaskaru. Namaskar, mama.
Mom.
Yes. Yukta vaivam. Atta atmanyam mat parayana. Engage your mind always in thinking of me. Become my devotee. Offer obeisance to me and worship me. Being completely absorbed in me, surely you will come to me.
Thank you so much, Mataji. Man man mama man bhakto madhyanji mam namaskuru mam evashi yuktaitam atmanam matpariyana. Engage your mind always thinking of me, become my devotee, offer obeisance to me and worship me. By being completely absorbed in me, surely you will come to me. Simple thing Krishna tells, that engage your mind always thinking of me. How to thinking of Krishna? The three things we have to do is listen, hearing, chanting and remembering. In this way we can remember Krishna in every situation, throughout our life. We can, throughout the day, we can thinking of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And in that way Krishna tells, you will be my, become my devotee. And wherever you see me, you are offer me obeisance. So obeisance me ulundu kumbarad. So when obeisance means, this is the example of obeisance. That's the devotee is doing. So offer me your obeisance. And by that, worship me. So easy thing. Krishna never tell that you have to do meditation, deed, that. No, Krishna never tell. Just think of me, chant my name. And wherever you see me, obeisance unto me. And by that, you will come and worship me. And by that, you will become a devotee. No worries. What is the heart of being Krishna's devotee? No hard and fast rules. Okay, by just chanting, you can actually become the devotee. You have already become devotee. And Prabhupada, once a reporter in England, asking Prabhupada, Swamiji, who is actually devotee? They are asking, who is actually devotee? They thinking that devotee means should be very strict. They should be very in sannyasi level. They have to always know, well versed in Sanskrit. They have to scrutinizingly read Bhagavad Gita. Prabhupada seeing that the reporter and simply saying that devotee means chanting, those who are chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and make others chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Very simple. Two things. One, those who are chant Hare Krishna and make others chant Hare Krishna is actually devotee. You don't have to think in so much way. No, Arjuna is simply hearing that like an innocent baby and listening whatever Krishna says. And he's doing whatever Krishna does, telling. He never do penance. He never do this meditation. He never stand in one leg. He never, our kaila rindu vibhodiya varavikkila. Indha mari endha vittegalum Arjuna panna kadaiyadu. Appaviya Krishna edhu solraro adu kekkiraar. So Krishna standing like an innocent man and listening to whatever Krishna tells. So by that, actually, we can come as a devotee of Krishna. And so by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, one immediately concentrate, one sound vibration, think of the lotus feet of the Lord, and very quickly one elevated the position of samadhi of trance. So one might tell that, Prabhu, practicing this meditation for so long years, now you are telling to change everything. You actually don't have to change everything. You just continue the meditation, but just one thing you have to add is this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So people sometimes, after waking up from their bed, they will always, some of people usually always practice this breathing system. Some of them will sit for 10 minutes silent. So some people have a different method. You don't have to actually change everything. You don't have to change. You just have to add one thing in your method is chant. It's all in one. Whatever you do, you might do yoga asanam. You might do meditation. You might do whatever you should, sitting silent or whatever. You just add one thing in that thing. One method is actually this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. By actually concentrating, not only chanting, by chanting, you put your ear together, hear the sound vibration, and that sound vibration will enter into ear and catch the mind. So one who chants Hare Krishna Mahamantra, the mind will go there with here. That is the actual nature of the mind. Will always go here and there. But you have to do exercise of the brain. Okay, we might do exercise of the body. But what is the exercise of brain? Is drag the brain and put it and concentrate on the sound. Okay, concentrate on the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. The mind will go run into other matter. You have to just pull at the brain. Come, sit down. Now you listen. And again, the mind will go there. So your work is to catch the mind. Put one. You don't think nonsense. You don't have to think nonsense. You only have to concentrate in Hare Krishna Mantra. So if you don't believe in this thing, tomorrow you wake up at early morning. Okay, that is the best time to chanting. It's in early morning because it's Brahma Muhurta time. So the world, there is no phone calls, no notification, no WhatsApp notification, no Instagram notification. So no one would wake up. So you bath, take your bath and sit down and chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. In that way, one will elevate position of samadhi or trance. You will become in that position. You will deeply absorb. So if one goes on chanting the holy name of the Lord, which is non-different from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So the holy name is Nam Nam Akari Bahuda Nija Sarva Shakti. The holy name is non-different from the God, and naturally his mind becomes absorbed. So this is the from Srimad Bhagavatam. So by this we can start chanting today. We might do the same rounds as yesterday, maybe 20 rounds, the same round. So maybe what's the your daughter's name, Mataji? Sushmita Mataji. What is your daughter's name? Ekanti Priya. Yes, Ekanti Priya, you can lead the chanting today. You can chant Hare Krishna for 20 times. You unmute and chant it loud to make everyone follow you. So you can lead the chanting today.
Okay.
Let's start chanting.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. So, thank you, Itinka Priya. Thank you very much. So please fill up the quiz. It is the proper group number, group 18. So, yes, any question and answer? Any question? So no question. So if no question, yeah, you all can leave. Thank you. We will see again tomorrow at the same time. So thank you. See you all tomorrow. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.